Hi everyone. In this lecture, we are going to see about how speech coding strategies are going to help in converting acoustic energy into electrical stimulations. Now, speech coding strategies does the work by converting the acoustic energy into electrical energy. This work is done by a microphone, but how this has to be done? There has a particular way in which the components of the signal, incoming signal, is converted or processed, then given to the electrode array to stimulate the auditory nerves in the cochlea. So this information has to account three primary factors of the incoming signal. They are the spectral information, which includes the frequency composition of the signal, the amplitude or intensity, which is going to contribute for the loudness perception, and the temporal information, which is the time varying component of the incoming signal, how the signal varies across time. All these three information is most crucial for speech perception or for any sound for that matter. So a set of rules that is used to code these factors into an electrical output signal is called speech coding strategy. And this speech coding strategy is an algorithm which will be stored in the speech processor of the external component of CI. The spectral information can be handled by a series of bandpass filters that corresponds to multi-channel intracochlear implant electrode array. It happens through place coding, where the basal electrodes are corresponding for high frequencies and apical electrodes are corresponding for low frequencies. The amplitude information is controlled by the charge level, the electrical energy level that is delivered for each electrode contact area. If the electrode contact is going to represent a soft signal, then lower charge is being delivered. If it is a loud signal, high intensity signal, then the charge is going to be high. The temporal information is extracted from the envelope extraction, how the signal varies across time. So these are the three information which is going to be extracted and processed in the speech processor of a CI. And the way in which it is going to do depends upon the speech coding strategy that is being selected. The basic steps that involves in speech process or speech coding in a cochlear implant are a sound window, which determines what are the sounds that needs to be picked up and processed. Once that is selected, this sound window is subjected to frequency mapping, where the sound is split into different frequency components, followed by amplitude mapping, how the signal is going to be represented in terms of its amplitude. Then mode of stimulation, how this process information is going to be delivered at the intracochlear electrode array, which will stimulate the auditory nerve fibers of the cochlea. So the sound window or amplitude mapping happens in a way where a normal acoustic hearing has a dynamic range of around 120 decibels. Among this 120 decibels of dynamic range, the very soft sounds and soft sounds does not have speech sound representation at a conversational level. Hence, these sounds are not going to help in speech perception. Also, the loud sounds can be compressed. So the microphone of the speech processor has its own dynamic range, which picks up the conversational level of the speech sounds and compresses louder sounds within its dynamic range. That is called as input dynamic range, the dynamic range of sound that a microphone picks up based on the pre-processing strategies. Now, this input dynamic range varies from 40 to 65 decibels. This dynamic range has to be compressed within the neural dynamic range. A neural dynamic range varies from 30 to 40 dB. When it comes to charge level or electrical hearing, electrical dynamic range, it is roughly around 15 to 20 decibels. Hence, the softest sound that is processed at the input dynamic range will be mapped to the T level or the threshold level of the electrical dynamic range. The loudest sound that is processed at the input dynamic range of the microphone will be mapped to the C level or the most comfortable level of the electrical dynamic range. This is how a sound window is mapped via the amplitude processing. This is what we are going to do in cochlear implant programming. At each and every channel, we are going to set at the D level and C level. Moving on to frequency mapping, it is controlled by intracochlear electrode array using multi-channel implants. So each and every electrode contact area has its own bandpass filters. So the microphone picks up the sound energy and splits the incoming energy into a series of bandpass filters. The output of these bandpass filters is delivered to the cochlea through appropriate or its own electrode contact area. Now if we see the color coding of the frequencies and the intracochlear electrode array, the low frequencies are corresponded or mapped to the electrode contact regions which reaches the apical end of the cochlea, and high frequencies are mapped to the contact regions at the basal end of the cochlea, thereby maintaining the tonotopic organization of the cochlea. The amplitude coding is done by extracting the envelope. So the incoming signal used various of bandpass filters is splitting the frequency components. Now how this signal varies across time, how the amplitude of the signal varies across time, this is extracted by envelope extractor, which includes rectification of the output from bandpass filters and low pass filtering it to extract the envelope. This envelope information is going to tell how the amplitude of the information or the incoming signal is varying across time in different channels. So this is how amplitude coding is going to happen, followed by mode of electrical stimulation. Yes, we have extracted the envelope. Now is this envelope going to be processed further or is going to be delivered as such to the intracochlear electrode array? So if it is delivered as such, then that is called as analog stimulation, a continuous stimulation. The signal is continuous and it is going to be stimulated through the electrode contact area in the intracochlear electrode array. So that is analog stimulation. If this analog is going to be converted to digital or by a train of biphasic pulses, then that is called as pulsatile stimulation. So electrical stimulation is of two types, analog and pulsatile. This pulsatile stimulation, the mode of delivery can be simultaneous stimulation or non-simultaneous stimulation. If it is simultaneous stimulation, then all the electrode contact areas fire or gets activated at the same time. If it is non-simultaneous, at any given point of time, no two channel or no two electrode contact area will be active at the same time. So that is non-simultaneous or interleaved stimulation. So these are the two modes of electrical stimulation, pulsatile stimulation. Now, the basic functioning of the speech processor in a cochlear implant is that the microphone of the speech processor picks up the incoming signal and converts it into electrical signal. Now that signal is classified or separated into its own frequency components using a series of bandpass filters. The output of these bandpass filters is rectified and low pass filtered to extract the envelope information. Then pulse generator is used to overlap the pulses to match the amplitude changes along the envelope. So this mixing will be done and the corresponding electrode will deliver this information into the auditory nerve fibers. So this block diagram is an example of continuous interleaved sampling. Speech coding strategies can be classified depending upon this type of stimulation, whether it is analog stimulation or pulsatile stimulation. The example of analog stimulation is compressed analog strategy and simultaneous analog strategy. The pulsatile stimulation strategies can further be divided into feature extraction strategy, peak picking strategies, and envelope extraction strategies. So these are the examples for different speech coding strategies. F0, F2, F0, F1, F2 and M-peak or multi-peak comes under feature extraction strategies, which is going to extract the speech features like fundamental frequency and formant frequencies. Then peak picking strategy. So across different channels, it is going to select the maximum energy channel. The peak will be picked up and only those information will be delivered to the intracochlear electrode array. And we have envelope extraction strategy, where all the channel output envelope is extracted and that is stimulated with biphasic pulses. Speech processing strategies can also be classified depending upon what type of cue it is using to process the incoming signal. So when it uses the spectral cues for processing the signal, then they are called as spectral coding strategies. The examples for spectral coding strategies are F0, F2, F0, F1, F2 and multi-peak strategies. The speech coding strategies that use temporal cues are compressed analog strategy, simultaneous analog strategy. The pulsatile strategies under temporal cues are continuous interlude sampling and its variants, PPS, MPS. And peak picking strategy of that uses temporal cues are N of M strategy or spectral peak. Advanced combined encoder. So this is one way of classifying the speech coding strategies. Later, in order to improve the speech perception noise and also to improve or enhance the music perception, fine structure processing came into existence. So till then, only the envelope waveform was used to analyze the signal or to process the incoming signal. So that envelope processing can be spectral envelope or temporal envelope. Then using fine features of the incoming signal, the spectral fine structure processing was used in Clarion device, first using Clarion device using virtual channels. And the speech coding strategy was named as high resolution 90K. The advanced form is high res 120. The feature or the speech coding strategy that uses temporal fine structure is fine structure processing and its variant, which is first used in Opus processor of Medal company. So these are different speech coding strategy depending upon whether they use spectral envelope information or temporal envelope information or spectral fine structure information or temporal fine structure information. Once we understand how are these speech coding strategies are classified, then we can go and look into how each and every speech coding strategy is going to convert the important information that is required for speech perception in individuals with cochlear implantees. These are the references used for this particular lecture. Thank you.